Well, there is a popular misconception that since Germany has a free education system or almost free education system, getting a scholarship is very difficult. Because of this, majority of the students either don't apply to the scholarships or are lost in the long list of scholarship database. For those who apply, give up after the first application. To counter such misconception, in this video, I will be sharing with you my secret tips based on which I was awarded 5 scholarships in 4 semesters. So let's get started. Hello everyone, my name is Parikshit and in the next few minutes, I will be explaining you everything about scholarships in Germany in 3 different sections. In the first section, we would be looking at different governing factors that you should highlight in your motivational letter. In the second section, we would be looking at a typical application process. In the third section, we would be looking at scholarship benefits. At the end of this video, I would be giving you a name of scholarship which I think you should definitely apply and you have a great chance of securing that scholarship. So starting with the first section, which is the deciding factor for any particular motivation letter. So if we look into different or individual scholarship, it would be a very exhaustive process. But trust me, I have been through different scholarship processes. I have won 5 scholarships at different level, university level, state level, national level. And I've been through the different finalist rounds for 3 other scholarships. So based on my experience, I can share with you 3 top factors that govern a motivational letter, of which the first factor is the academic performance. Well, academic performance is the major factor for any scholarship. There is no substitute for that particular thing. No one expects that you should have a complete or absolute 1.0 pointer, but anything in the range of 1.3, 1.7 increases your chances of getting a scholarship. Academic performance shows evaluator that okay, you are very serious about your studies. Moving on to the second factor, which is the social engagement. Well, majority of the students underestimate the importance of social engagement. Well, you are in Europe and you should know that social engagement is of high importance. It could be of any form. You could give tutoring lessons to the juniors, academic tutoring lessons. It could be like arranging intercultural events for the college, or it could be like volunteering for a social organization like Red Cross associations. These social engagements show the evaluators that you are not a selfish person who is only after the scholarship money, but you are someone who likes to give it back to the society. And even after winning scholarship, you would definitely give back to the society. The third factor is regarding the purpose of the scholarship. There is a misconception that what is the particular purpose of the scholarship, or this basically means that why you need this scholarship for. If you are writing that I need this scholarship for the repayment of education loan, dude, that's a complete cliche. Everyone writes it. So you should know that basically the scholarships are given for your career, academic, professional, as well as cultural development. So you should write something in this direction. It could be like you want to participate in a particular technical event which is costly, or language course, or any professional development event. This shows the evaluator that you are a prudent and can responsibly handle money and the benefits of scholarships. So in short, these were the 3 factors which should be highlighted in your motivational letter so that you could increase the chances of getting a scholarship. Well, you just got an idea about what to write in a motivational letter for scholarship. Now, we would be looking at a typical application process. This application process is divided into 3 steps. In the first step, you should look for scholarships. Now, you should know where to look for scholarships. I would highly suggest you to first look for the scholarships at the university or the international office portal. I already mentioned this in my admission process video that the ideal time to ask or inquire about the scholarship is in the admission process itself. If you miss that chance, then in the first semester, you should definitely ask about different possibilities of scholarship at your university. Well, if you don't find anything here, then you could definitely move on to the different scholarship database. For example, DART database, or there could be different private databases. The issue with these scholarship database is that there are thousands of scholarship listed, but after spending hours, you find that only a couple of scholarships are really useful. So better focus on quality rather than quantity. Moving on to the second step. Second step is profile building. Now work hard on your academics. It is completely okay if you don't have a very exceptional grade in your bachelor's. Now is your chance. Now you can start afresh in your master's studies. Then you could also get involved in the social engagement. You could organize intercultural events, you could do volunteering, or you could do tutoring, or get involved in this mentorship program. Third thing is the application process itself. Now, in the application process, you have to remember, the major reason for rejection of application or scholarship application is the incompleteness of documents. If the documents are incomplete, your application is going to get rejected. Very straightforward. So just ensure the completeness of your application. Then make sure as soon as the time frame for application starts, you apply in a week or two. Possibly there would be some doubts about the requirements or the document requirements. Just clear it in 1 or 2 weeks and then apply. Just apply as soon as possible. For application, either it could be the portal application, you have to upload something on portal, or it could be sent via post. So that you have to check based on different scholarships. So this was a typical scholarship application process. Now we can move on to the benefits. Coming to the benefits of scholarship, here I would be listing three major benefits. Firstly, it's about professional and social network. As far as professional network is concerned, I would give the example of Deutschland Stipendium. Deutschland Stipendium is a program which is collaboration between German Ministry of Education and Research and an industry partner. With this industry partner, you have a good chance of getting an internship or a master thesis project, which you could later convert it to a full-time job. As far as social network is concerned, the best example is the Baden-Württemberg Scholarship. The team at Baden-Württemberg Scholarship or Baden-Württemberg Foundation makes sure or arranges different social events throughout the year, and one of the most amazing part is that you along with your partner becomes a lifetime member of this particular foundation and get each and every invitation to these events. So all the students who are studying in Baden-Württemberg, I would highly recommend you to apply for the scholarship. Second benefit of scholarship is the financial benefit. Now, I would say that finances or the financial benefit should not be a main motive for applying to a scholarship. We all know that the education in Germany is already subsidized. So there won't be any lot of money involved in the scholarship payments or scholarship amount. A typical scholarship is around 300 to 600 euros per month, and the total scholarship amount is somewhere around 2000 to 3000 euro in total. So there are also individual scholarships which range somewhere around 500 to 1000 euros, but that depends upon different scholarships. So you have to check what is the amount of scholarship, but again, the finances should not be a main motivation behind the scholarship. The third reason is your job and career prospect. Scholarships are highly rewarding and are seen as a major achievement in Germany. So this exponentially increases your job as well as career prospects. Well, as promised, now I would be revealing the name of the scholarship which I think you should definitely apply, and that is eFellows Scholarship. The application process for this eFellows Scholarship is as simple as uploading the CV, filling in the personal details and clicking submit. There are no monetary benefits or direct monetary benefits involved with the scholarship, but this scholarship provides indirect benefits in the form of free liability insurance for 1 year, then different free tax filing softwares for 1 year, and then there are different events. For example, there are different workshops, for example, assessment center workshops, which would be very important during your job application phase. So I would highly recommend you to apply for the scholarship after the second or third semester of your master's or bachelor's studies. Well, I would be more than happy if after watching this video, you secure a scholarship. But just remember one thing, don't stop at one, strive hard and just aim for the next scholarship. Now, if you think that this video has given you interesting information or has motivated you to apply for scholarship, then feel free to give a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. I would be coming up with similar interesting videos in the coming weeks so that you make informed decisions.